Hello learners, with today's greeting, I am Professor Naseeb Singh Gill from Department of Computer Science and Applications and Director, Digital Learning Initiatives and Monitoring Cell of Maharishi Dayanand University, Rohtak, Haryana. In the last two decades, the world has witnessed a significant growth in number of devices such as mobiles, laptops, tablets, iPads, and wearables connected to internet, along with timely revolutions in network bandwidth and the telecom network generations such as 3G, 4G, 5G, and 6G. The advancements in technology and plethora of powerful and innovative digital devices and tools have a great potential to improve educational outcomes. Educators and learners of 21st century need to understand that the use of digital contents and devices will improve teaching and learning and thus enhance educational opportunities and benefit the millennial. So now let's step forward and discuss the second module of this program under technology supported pedagogical innovations, which is mobile computing technology. First of all, let's have a look at the learning outcomes of this present module. At the end of this module, learners will be able to understand concept of mobile computing technology, use of Wi-Fi for mobile computing, concept of mobile learning, understanding mobile learning versus e-learning, factors gearing up faster adoption of mobile learning, benefits of mobile learning, emergence of mobile app industry and its future, concept of mobile cloud and mobile cloud computing technology. Mobile phones have completely dominated our lives, from communication and entertainment to socializing and learning. Mobile technology puts everything in the palm of your hand. It has changed our lives forever. Examples include such as access for everyone. It gets you new range of businesses. It is nothing but a everything device. It provides ability to find information when you need it. It connects people. It gets you personalized experiences. The emerging technologies and tools have changed the styles for learning. Digital learning adds up to a personalized, transformed, and accelerated learning experience that gives learner power to be in the driver's seat. Now, let's understand what is mobile computing technology. Mobile computing is a technology that allows transmission of data, voice, and video via a computer or any other wireless enabled device without having to be connected to a fixed physical link. So now let's understand the basics of mobile computing. Mobile devices include cell phones and other portable devices. Mobile computing can use cell phone connections to make phone calls as well as to connect to the internet. These include laptops, smartphones, tablets, wearable computers such as Apple Watch. Wi-Fi is a wireless technology that we also need to understand. It allows an electronic device to exchange data over the internet via radio waves. Devices such as laptops, tablets, and smartphones can hook into Wi-Fi by choosing a Wi-Fi network or through a hotspot, which can be found anywhere in offices, restaurants, institutions of higher learning, schools, colleges, universities, recreational facilities, and some public areas, and also at home. At home, you will need a wireless router connected to your broadband internet. When you leave the hotspot area, your mobile device will disconnect from the internet. Wi-Fi range is generally about 100 feet, although it can depend on the network too. Now let's explore as what is mobile learning and why is it becoming popular among learners. Mobile learning, also known as m-learning, is a education via the internet or network using personal mobile devices such as tablets and smartphones to obtain learning materials through mobile apps, social interactions, and online educational hubs. Mobile learning is flexible, allowing students access to education anywhere and anytime. It should not be confused with e-learning. As technology evolved, lessons were not only delivered to mailboxes, but also reached learners on their computers or laptops. Thus, e-learning developed, and now learning is being delivered to their handheld devices, where they can consume it on the go. Although e-learning and m-learning are used interchangeably in many cases, the two modes of learning differ in many aspects. Now let's understand the difference between e-learning and mobile learning. As number one, very clear from its name, e-learning means electronic learning that refers to a form of education where learning instruction is delivered via the internet using electronic devices like PCs and laptops. On the other hand, mobile learning refers to where knowledge is disseminated to learners through handheld or portable devices. Number two, they differ at objective. In a sense, e-learning takes on a structured, formal, and time-bound format of teaching, whereas m-learning, on the other hand, is described as on-demand, timely, and context-aware form of education dissemination. Number three, medium of delivery. E-learning is primarily delivered through computers and laptops, and also may involve the use of video conferencing equipment or software, whereas mobile learning is delivered to learners or students over their smartphones and or tablets or through a specific learning app. Number four, time gap between assessment. With e-learning tools, there is usually a significant amount of time between knowledge dissemination and application of practical solutions in tests, whereas mobile learning has a short gap between learning and application of the learned material. When someone is learning through mobile learning format, one is mostly required to make informed decisions and apply solutions immediately. Number five, design. With e-learning, learning is disseminated through large, big LCD screens for live HD video streaming of lessons, whereas mobile learning platform allows for sharing of learning information through through mobile devices. That means mobile learning files are designed for simple screens and simple navigation. Number 6, learning duration. In case of your e-learning programs, not only feature more complex graphics, but are also designed to allow learners to sit and learn for longer periods of time. On the other hand, mobile learning systems are designed for corporate learners and smartphone users who have limited time to learn. In a nutshell, we see that e-learning and mobile learning have some significant differences, but that does not mean one of them is better than the other. In fact, mobile learning can perfectly be blended with e-learning to supplement course delivery. Now, let's understand what makes mobile technology adoption much faster in learning process. Smartphones. Most of us use smartphones extensively during our day. Using this for learning is a logical extension. Number 2, change in learner profiles. Globally, the workforce has an increasing number of millennials. As a digital initiative, this generation is addicted to using mobile devices. Number 3, flexible formats. Learners prefer formats that engage them better, such as videos, animated videos, interactive videos, or podcasts. Number 4, learning device of learner choice. Rather than be told how to consume training, today's learners want the flexibility to learn on the device of their choice. Number 5, bring your own device. That is BYOD policy. Increasingly, organizations are opting for bring your own device policy, giving learners the control to learn on the devices of their choice. Number 6, minimal LMS, that is learning management system. Learners want the learning to be part of their workflow, avoiding the need to log into the LMS, that is learning management system, all the times. Number 7, learners' view on how they want to learn. Learners ask for learning at their moment of choice. The push for just-in-time learning aids that are available on learners' mobile devices is very high. Now let's learn as what are the main benefits of mobile learning. Mobile learning offers better learner engagement and higher completion rates. Key benefits of mobile learning includes several. Number 1, learning on the go. The biggest advantage of mobile learning is its main capability to offer anytime, anywhere learning on the go. Number 2, flexibility to learners. Mobile learning offers tremendous flexibility to learners to choose the device they wish to learn on, when they want to learn, and most significantly, at the pace they like. Number 3, multi-device support. Mobile learning designs support all devices and all learners' needs. The same courses run seamlessly across laptops, desktops, and tablets or smartphones. Number 4, more options to create engaging learning. Microlearning has changed the format of training delivery. You can integrate mobile apps for learning in your overall strategy. Number 5, interesting design formats to learn from. Mobile learning features design formats that are popular with learners and also create a better retention and recall through videos, animated videos, and interactive videos. Now let's learn how fast the mobile app industry is growing. Emergence of mobile app industry. Mobile app industry with plethora of smart devices, controllers, sensors, etc. has evolved at a rapid pace. And demand for applications that can be used to control, track, and monitor these devices would be immense. These apps would act or serve as a bridge between the Internet of Things, that is IoT objects, and the user by providing a comprehensive, easy to use user interface to furnish an augmented user experience. Several mobile app development trends have taken place in the year 2008 and beyond, which are likely to be very popular. First of these is Internet of Things. Number two, artificial intelligence. Number four, virtual reality and augmented reality. Seeing the already developed applications, especially in home automation, it has become increasingly evident that Internet of Things devices become more useful and valuable when they are complemented with apps for mobile devices like smartphones, tablets, and wearables. Now let's learn about mobile cloud computing and future learning. Mobile computing technology and its future of mobile cloud computing is nothing but the combination of cloud computing, mobile computing, and wireless networks to bring rich computational resources to mobile users, network operators, as well as cloud computing providers. The goal of mobile cloud computing is to enable execution of rich mobile applications on mobile devices with a rich user experience. Mobile cloud computing merges the fast-growing cloud computing applications market with the ubiquitous smartphone. It has proved itself to be highly beneficial to all the mobile users and cloud-based service providers as well. Mobile cloud computing confirms the impact of certain trends and factors. Here are the factors that have had an amazing impact as far as mobile cloud computing is concerned, such as enhanced broadband coverage. It provides better connectivity, which is being rendered to our mobile devices via 4G, Wi-Fi, femtocells, fixed wireless, etc. Next, abundant storage. Cloud-based mobile apps have proved themselves to be more capable than any smartphone, especially in terms of the storage space that is offered. Number three, budding technologies. Advanced technologies like HTML5, CSS3, hypervisor virtual machines for smartphones, cloudlets, and Web4, etc. These are contributing a lot. Latest trends. Smartphones have enabled us with 24/7 access to applications and other collaborative services with scope to increase the productivity from anywhere at any given time. Now, let's explore its limitations too. There are few limitations too, which includes number one, data security. Data security is one of the major concerns of cloud computing. You need to choose the most reliable service provider who can keep your data totally safe and secure. Number two, connectivity and performance issues. Sometimes you may feel that performance is not up to the mark. Hence, it is better to check the track record of your service provider before undertaking any service. Number three, dependency and vendor lock-in. Sometimes it becomes difficult to migrate from a service provider, and this is what it is called vendor lock-in. It is very important to check the terms and conditions and other options before picking a vendor, as later it can become difficult to switch to some other providers. I hope that you would have enjoyed the present module on mobile computing technology, which plays a pivotal role in pedagogical innovations. We will join you soon with another module focused on technology-supported pedagogical innovations. Thank you.